This is a Pod Dealers Network podcast.
I need to issue a quick apology. I just want to say to Andrew, I'm sorry. I think I took things a little too far, and it has come to my attention that you may or may not be a real person. You know, for some reason, even though you did not attend the school that my daughter attends right now, you still seem to be a ever-present entity in whatever nonsense is going on. So, you know, my bad. That's me, you know, listening to a five-year-old. You know, it happens. If you're a kid named Andrew and you feel threatened, or parents of a child named Andrew and you feel threatened somehow, I apologize.
What is TWS podcast, episode, whatever, who cares at this point?
The rant of the vindicated.
It's my podcast and I do what I want to.
People, listen.
Word, is it still live?
It's not working for me, Rip. We're going to keep going.
I know I changed my voice at work.
Bars on the radio.
What is TWS podcast?
When's ready?
I feel like the end is
staring at my watch and I'm feeling so new school.
Suicide attempts, how many tries to take?
Damn, ready.
Back to the real niggas glowing in the dark. Never perfect, but you know a nigga hard. A rich nigga that'll pull up to the park. Get on one knee and tell a kiss that they are stars.
Stars.
Bullet wounds don't be covered by Obamacare. Your funeral is way too soon, as if your mama there. Real niggas deserve to live twice. Plastic fork is for fried rice.
Yeah, 2.2 for the Raffian and Dow.
We're going to fade out on the Drake part. Anyway, welcome to another episode of the What Is TWS podcast. As always, I'm your boy, J.Dot Flam, representing the White Pants Society. And I want to thank you, first and foremost, for taking some time out of your day to sit, chill with me, listening to the, I don't know, whatever nonsensical conversation I have with myself every week. Appreciate y'all for being patient this week. Episode is a little late, and I'm explaining why in a bit, but you know, I didn't want to let this streak in, you know, for you. You could be anywhere else in the world, but you're here with me, and I greatly appreciate that, which is why I believe you deserve content on time, and I apologize. All kinds of apologies this week. But yeah, man, started out, I just want to, because I'm going to go into more, I had more time with Chef Elise, so the Chef Elise segment is going to be a little longer than usual, maybe the majority of the episode. So the other things I want to talk about, I'm going to try to knock out real quick before we get there. I know they're doing things out of order. Everything's crazy this week. Just, you know, I don't know. And it's the moment. We're going to live in it. Anyway, I wanted to start out with that, you know, albums dropped. Opinions have been stated. I guess there's a beef. I don't know. I don't pay attention to a lot of it. I don't understand a lot of it. And there's certain stuff that I refuse to speak on ever again. I did go ahead and stream, you know, Certified Lover Boy. I like how he's just like this. That's, it feels to me the way I have to embrace this bougie, you know, white Oreo type thing that's been attached to me. Like, yeah, I think he's just embraced that thing. Now he's Certified Lover Boy. That cover art was whatever it was. But yeah, man, I streamed it, and you know, I don't feel like I'm not. This is not a review of the album. I'm just, you know, sharing a few of my thoughts. I can't remember exactly how many tracks are on it. I probably have like four that, you know, are songs I will return to at some point that I've played, you know, multiple times since the album's drop, which I'm not sure is a great ratio versus the number of songs that's on the album. I heard before it was dropping that, like, it was going to be, like, he was saying, like, this was a straight rap album. And I was like, dope. I've been wanting, you know, to hear Drake just bar out for however many tracks. And like, I had high hopes, and I really, and maybe it's not, you know, maybe the album and there are songs on the album that are better than I'm giving them credit for in the moment, because I walked into it wanting to hear Drake just bar out for however many songs was on this joint. And that's not, I don't feel like that's what I got. The couple of songs that stand out to me are the ones that's what he does. I don't know what it is about, like, random times in the morning on specific streets that do something for him, But yeah, that's 7 a.m. on Bridal Path. I think standout joint, you know, Drake barring out. And it's coherent, which is important, which I'll get to in a second. The Champagne Poetry to start out, I think was an amazing intro. Like, I love that beat. I kind of dig the, you know, the confidence to do, you know, offbeat, you know, bars. Just like it, just presenting it, I guess, in spoken word, or that is poetry. I mean, it's clearly rap, but he didn't give a fuck about the beat. He just said words when he felt like saying them. But I dig it. It's cool. What else is on the album that I like? I was looking forward to the Jay track. You know, I was happy that there was an album that I was allowing myself to listen to with a new Jay verse on it, and that I could actually hear this one. And you know, and it was going to be on a Drake song. I feel like Jay definitely, you know, plays to his competition. I ain't gonna say, I mean, he does good work regardless, but if he knows he's on the track with a hitter, he's going, you know, he's going to go. And I, you know, I don't know how I feel like the verse was, you know, emotionally there. Like, it was, that's a story I don't know that we've heard his side of, you know, so far. You know, they had a close friend to actually try to kill him. And I guess there's pressure in his camp somewhere to be friendly. I don't know. Whatever. It just, it wasn't as technically proficient. Like, man, I put Drake on this pedestal in terms of, like, rapping. You know, I don't think there are many rappers who can rap as well as Drake does. You know, bars and, you know, multi-syllabic rhyme schemes and stuff. Like, I'm very technical when it comes to, like, you know, rappers. And I put Drake up there. And I just, like, and he, when he wants to hit that high watermark, he hits it every time effortlessly, which is, you know, which is another one of the things that makes him so great to me. But he just don't give a fuck about doing it that often, and that drives me insane. The crazy thing is, and I'll share this, and then I'm gonna get off the album, because I don't feel like this is an entertaining conversation at all. But the crazy thing is, like, the one song where it's like three of, you know, the best rappers of right now, in terms of, you know, being lyricists, probably, like, barring out, is, and I'm a, people often tell me the way I listen to music is not the way everybody else listens to music. So, like, when I thought about talking about this, it feels pretentious to me. It feels like, you know, I'm telling you something that I'm sure you already know, but for some reason, when I have conversations with people and, like, I dissect things in this manner, they seem like, that's a, you know, that's a perspective you don't hear very often. So I'm going to share it anyway. And if it is pretentious, y'all can tell me, I'll never do it again. Fuck it, though. So that joint, you only live twice. Like, that to me was three rappers that are dope rappers that was just like barring out over a pretty, you know, a nice beat, whatever. And when I listen to it, you know, as a person that used to write, what I can tell you, the crazy thing about that song is that those are throwaway bars, man. Those are absolutely throwaway. I ain't have no other use for them. Shit in the back of the notebook if they still writing. Shit in their phone. Verses that was unfinished. Those are absolutely throwaway bars. They don't match each other. There's no consistent tone. There's no consistent rhyme scheme, with the exception of Wayne. Wayne clearly, like, you can tell. Like, they picked a beat that had a break every four bars or so. So you don't even have to, like, work to transition between rhyme schemes. You can have one rhyme scheme here, just take a break, and then say something like, yeah, and then go into something completely different, unrelated, different rhyme scheme, different cadence, different everything. And it just sound like a bunch of sections of bars that they had that didn't fit with each other, that they ain't know what else to do with. And they put it on this song, which is supposed to be, like, great rappers being great rappers. And it sounds dope, but it's fucking, like, hilariously nonsensical. Like, and Ross is the worst offender of the bunch. You know, like Weezy's verse is not crazy sensical in terms of, like, what he talks about. Like, he's talking about the same things he always talks about. But you can hear that it's coherent. Like, it's a rhyme scheme that continues. If the rhyme scheme changes, there are transitions to you know, acknowledge that change. Like it, and there's no, he doesn't use those breaks. He don't use those breaks in the beat to pause and then come back on something completely different. Like he's just, it's a stream of thoughts, a stream of consciousness straight through. The other ones, I think, you know, Drake probably uses more. He probably does some, maybe 6-bar, 8-bar sections. But the majority of it is just 4-bar, blah, 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 blah. All right, next point, completely different. I ain't even talking about that no more. Yeah. But Ross joint to me is just hilarious. Like, it's shit that just clearly don't even make sense right next to each other. And I'm going to say this, and I'm going to get off this for real. That is, like, the worst for him last 2 bars to a verse of all time for Ross. And it, but it sounds so dope. But it's so stupid, and like it's just for a dude that used to be a big dude. Like I was just waiting for like the ugh. Like I was like, that's what I expected to hear, that ugh, whatever that song sound he used to make when he was fat. That's what I was expected to hear at the end. But I, you listen to that song, and listen to them last 2 bars from Ross, and like tell me if it just don't hit different when you actually pay attention to what the fuck it says, and it's not just how he said it, like. Real niggas deserve to live twice. Plastic fork and fried rice. Like, what? I know one of y'all is going to, like, explain it to me and tell me how it makes sense, but it don't. It don't. You save your breath. You know, it don't. It just, it sounded dope at the end of a bunch of other nonsensical stuff. And, but yeah, I guess that's how, Royce calls them Lego raps. You snap them together, and that's what that song sounded like to me. A bunch of Lego raps snapped together. And it made for a dope song. It's a dope song. I'm going to listen to it again. I enjoy it. But now I kind of laugh a little bit when I listen to it because I don't know. Plastic forks and fried rice. Ugh. I don't know. I don't know what you could have done with that one. Anyway, I'm going to get a Certified Lover Boy. I actually listened to that one, and that's why I'm going to talk about it. I didn't talk about other stuff because I didn't listen to it. But, all right. So this is why the episode is late this week. And this is why... this may not be my best episode, or it may be all over the place. So I had my daughter. I picked up Sheffy Lise Friday after school, and she went home. Today is Monday. It's Monday at about 6:00 in the evening. She went home around 12:30 today. And if you're not in shape for it, like if it's something that you don't do, like this has been the most extended daddy daughter time I've had in quite some time, and just ever. And then at when she's 5, like I think I've had her for time periods when she was, you know, a baby, and you know, if you put her in a spot, she was gonna stay in that spot. Now she's 5, and if wherever she is, if I turn my head and turn back, she's not there anymore. She's somewhere else doing something else, getting into something else that she's not supposed to be getting into. And, you know, this is my first, like, bachelor pad-ish apartment. There's shit in here that's not for kids. And, you know, it's not a kid-friendly environment all the time. I try to transition it around when she's coming. But obviously, I don't do that great a job because this weekend was just, I just bounced from one place to another. I've never been so exhausted in my life, like, shouts to moms, like shouts to people who do this, shouts to anybody who do, let me not, you know, get gender specific or whatever, but shouts to anybody who does this on a consistent, regular basis. Like this was a 3-day weekend that I didn't go to work, but I worked harder for these last 3 days than I have in weeks. It's like, I don't feel rested, and I got 8 hours of sleep. Like my phone or whatever is telling me that like I got 8 hours, almost 9 hours of sleep last night. And I feel like not rested at all. Like I've never been this tired before. I couldn't even nap after she left. Like I feel I can't even explain it, man. This is crazy. We went swimming. I got her a swim cap, and that was a whole ordeal, like getting hair. Like nobody tells you these things. Like, I don't know. Like, it's, you know, her hair's not supposed to get wet. The shower cap thing looked retarded. That looked, you know, super, ghetto is the only word I can think of. I hate when people call shit ghetto, but whatever. Yeah, the shower cap idea, that wasn't cool. So I went and got her a swim cap. But you know how hard it is to put a swim cap on somebody's head, like, and like not hurt them. I don't know. That was just one like 2 hour block of our weekend. And then just having a person around you that is constantly talking and not just constantly talking and expecting you to have a response and expecting you to have an answer for everything that they're saying, that they're constantly saying, that they don't stop saying the entire time that they're around you, and you love them. And so you want to meet their expectations. You want to be a dad that knows everything, a dad that is listening and cares and is interested, but it's not interesting and they won't stop talking about it and asking you questions about it. Oh man, this was, and now like I almost understand why I've had issues sometimes, like the issues that my ex-wife and I used to have, because after 2 or 3 days of this, like I was quickly irritated. Like anything irritated me. Sunday morning, I was setting it up to take her to this trampoline house, and we had a great time when we got there. But just the process of buying tickets to the trampoline house, everything just seemed like an extra hoop to go through, and I was getting so like pissed off about nothing that whole morning. I had packages that were supposed to be delivered. FedEx told me they were delivering, and now they delivery exceptions, so my package ain't showing up. So the one thing I was like looking forward to break up like this nonstop dad life situation, like, is not coming. And like I was damn near in tears when I found out the packages weren't coming, because I just I don't know, I needed it for some reason, and I was just super pissed off. I didn't care that like there's been flooding all over the place and hurricanes and shit. It's like, fuck it, you said my package was gonna be here and now it's not gonna be here, and now I gotta keep talking to this little girl about stuff I don't want to talk to about no more. I can't watch no more Peppa Pig or Bluey or Six Slime Sam or whatever it is. I can't do it. Chasing her all around trampoline parks, and we had a great time at the trampoline park. That was a good dad move. I had to choose between a Van Gogh exhibit, the immersive Van Gogh thing, or trampoline park. And it's not my proudest moment, because it really came down to economics. It was like, the Van Gogh thing looked really cool, and it looked like she might get in there and be like, oh my God, yay, look at that, wow, you know. And it could have been a huge hit, but it was a risk. It was going to be like $200, you know, for the tickets and getting out there and getting back. And I was going to have to put up that kind of money for the possibility of it being a good dad move. Or, you know, the tickets to the trampoline thing was like $10. I could spend $40, get tickets, pizza, fruit snacks, icy, the whole shebang a bang. And I know I'm winning on this. Like, this a can't miss right here. This is a can't miss. She get to run around, jump on stuff. Like, and it's okay and it's cool. Like, she just get to jump the entire time, and that's what you're supposed to be doing. Can't miss. So, yeah, that's what it came down to. I do want to, like, I want to expose her to stuff and shit like that, but yeah, I can see why you would choose. I had to do what I had to do. I needed to tire her out. I needed something, and that didn't work. I don't know what they feed kids or what. I don't. She's just never tired. If y'all can't tell, like, I'm beat, but I had a great time with my little girl. We didn't do a whole lot of recipes. She helped me make some lemon curd, which I put lime zest in because I'm freestyling. I'm trying things out. I'm feeling cocky these days. Put a little lime juice, lime zest in. So it's lemon lime curd. Like, it's like Sprite curd, something different. Living outside the box. What else did we do? We did mug cakes last night. We did chocolate mug cakes for the first time, and it was too chocolatey. Like, according to a 5-year-old, just be one. Like, can you know what I mean? Like, I'm getting it, and if I have ever not sympathized with a parent at any point in my life, my apologies. Like, you know, because just after a weekend like this, to be making a mug cake with this little girl, and then like it'd be finished and you're eating it. And I killed my mud cake because it was delicious. And it was too chocolatey. I asked you if you wanted chocolate or vanilla, and you said chocolate, and now we made chocolate, but it's too chocolatey. It's too much of the thing that's in the name to describe what it is. Whew, woosah, people. But you can't say that to a 5-year-old. So I didn't. In case anybody's trying to judge me, I didn't. But that's why this episode is late. Because, yeah, Sunday, I couldn't figure out a way to get it done while I still had her. I thought about, like, having her on the show, which seemed sort of exploitive. Like, I didn't want to do that to my little girl. And it was not going to be interesting. Y'all didn't want to, I don't know. Like, y'all don't want to hear that. Y'all really don't. I don't want to hear it. So, I love my daughter. I love my little girl. But that's it. And so, I had to wait until she left. And then I just was not, even right now, like, I can't focus. Like, I'm exhausted. Like, I don't know what this episode is about. I don't know what the title is going to be. I'm out of it. I'm out of it. And this is just what, you know, no breaks. Like, no school to drop her off at. It was no breaks. It was just constant. It was one continuous shot. Like, it was a movie where they made the movie in one continuous camera shot. Like, that's what this was. It never stopped. You know, when I went to sleep, it was right after putting her to bed. And when I woke up, it was because she was coming into my room. And, yeah. And oddly enough, like, I miss it. You know, I wish I could complain about this more often. I miss my little girl. But it is what it is. All right. This has been all over the place. And we about to go further into the weeds. Because I've been talking a lot about just how my weeks go. And I had an interesting experience earlier this week. And I just wanted to share it with the people. Because I think this is something that, ladies, you need to hear. And so, you know, often you might see on classifieds and stuff where, you know, people have random encounters. That sounds sexual. When people just you meet somebody somewhere or whatever, and you don't get a chance to exchange names or anything like that, and you're trying to connect with them later. I'm really not trying to connect with this person. I'm just trying to give them a tip that'll help us both. So I'm talking to the lady that was in the white Beamer. I'm going to give away my location. On Palm Springs Road here in Austin, you was in a white Beamer driving past a bus stop. I just want to say it's cool. It's okay. You can look. You can look, and that's not a problem. You was in a car, a BMW at that, and I was at a bus stop. So we both knew nothing was going to come out of it, like nothing. We was in two different spaces. We in two different places in our lives, and that's cool. You know, I'm just saying, like, if you wanted to look, I was feeling in a zone that morning. Like, I was feeling in a good place that morning. I think I had already tweeted out that, like, I was on my new school shit. Like, none of my colors matched or whatever. I was really feeling like I was doing something different, and it was working for me. So it's okay. You can acknowledge it. You can look. It's not a problem. It is cool. You don't got to side eye it, whatever. Just look. I felt like I was having a handsome day. It don't happen all the time. So, you know, when it do, feel free to enjoy it and let me enjoy it. You know, we helping each other out. This is a mutual, situation. And it's a couple moments while you waiting at a light and I'm sitting at a bus stop where I get to feel special for a minute and you get to enjoy the beauty that was me on that particular day. You know, I do it for you anyway. I do it for you anyway. Skincare, shaving, cologne, ironing clothes. That shit we do for y'all. Like, if I could get away with it any other way, I probably... Nah, that sounds horrible. I do like to be clean. But some of the other shit, like, I don't enjoy sitting in barber's chairs. But I do it because I'm trying to, you know... I'm giving you a gift. I'm giving a gift to the world. So please, you know, take it. I can't look back at you. We couldn't have that kind of moment. Because that's the kind of thing that gets me sued. Lawsuits. That's like sexual harassment. I don't know if you can do it from a bus stop looking into a car. But I'm not trying to find out the hard way. So I can't reciprocate that action. Because y'all get it all the time. And I get it that it's like if you get this, just like with my daughter, right? Like if you have it all the time, you might, it's annoying. Like, it's like, I would love a break from that. If you never have it, then you're like, yes, please, I'll take that thing that you think is annoying. I would love some of that. Give me all of that. That's all I'm saying. You know how you feel about it, but I don't get that. I don't get that too often. So just, I don't know, it's good for the spirit. It helps me out, you know. And then, I don't know, it just seemed like you was, that had to have been stressful, trying to pull off the side eye maneuver that you was doing through the glares early in the morning, whatever. Just go on, look. And this goes for the lady in the barbershop too, I remember. And this is how important it is. Like, this is how much it does something for us, because I remember this. This was years ago. But, you know, that's what I was in the barbershop for, ma'am. I was in there so that somebody would look at me and be like, man, he fine as shit. And you can say, don't say it under your breath. Say it out loud. I'm going to respond. I'm going to say, you beautiful too. And I ain't even got to look at you to know it. You beautiful because you said it. You beautiful because you gave me that moment. Your spirit is beautiful. That's what I'm trying to say. Let me know that I didn't waste my money in that barber chair. Let me know that, you know, I'm having a good day. Help me. I mean, don't nothing got to come from it. I'm not that dude. There may be some dudes out there that's going to try to take that too far. I'm not one of them. Maybe we could work something out where if they're wearing a TWS t-shirt, you know that they're not one of those dudes that's going to take it too far. So it's okay to, you know, shoot them a compliment or to, you know, to look outright without having to make it weird. I'm just saying, you know, as with anything, I feel like we give the attention to the things that we don't like. You know, we will talk about, we'll stare at a car accident brazenly, but you see an attractive man at the bus stop, you know, it's like you gotta be coy about it. Like, nah, let's, if we put our energy into the things we like, we enjoy, we want to see, you know, we'll see more of it. You know, this is a bad example, but I'm trying to turn this into a something positive, because I can't focus right now, people. I can't. But I don't know, man. You know, let me be great. Let me be great. I will say this about the Drake album. It makes me want to rap. He makes me want to rap, because he got that everyman, you know, life shit. I wish he didn't do like all the super expensive, extravagant lifestyle raps, because we don't live that shit and we don't know the fuck you talking about half the time, Drake. I'm not trying to look up some stuff I can't afford just so I could get a bar. Hey, you could have said that far more simply, or just not thrown the reference in there for what. I got to look up all these now. I don't know who Rizzuto or whatever it is you be talking about. I digress. I rambled for an hour. We did it. Not an hour, for half an hour. See, this is how much I can't focus. I'm out of it. The nap I'm about to take is going to be epic. I really couldn't even rest after she left, because I knew I had like this hanging over my head that I had not put out an episode or recorded anything for an episode. And I didn't feel comfortable. Like, I couldn't really relax until I knew I had gotten this done. So now I can relax. I don't know what the fuck this episode is or has been. Dude, shouts to moms. Whatever. If there's anything that you take away from this, just shouts to moms. Shouts to anybody who cares for children. You all are amazing. You are the real MVPs. I don't know how you do it. It's only been 3 days, and I'm probably going to need a few days to recover until I'm back to normal. So, let's get these calls to action out the way so I can take a nap. As usual, you know, my man, Zaya Fitness, he is doing big things. He is doing yoga on the roof. He can get your nutrition and your fitness goals together. So if you are looking to get right, I know, you know, summertime is over. So, yeah, I guess there ain't no more suns out, guns out. But it's still cuffing season. So if you want to be, you know, cuddled up, I don't know, in the right, who knows where this is going. Zaya Fitness, he will get you right with your nutrition and your fitness goals. Z-A-Y-A-H Fitness on Instagram. Hit them up. Get you where you need to be. If you're looking for ways to be impactful, if you're looking for ways to have a beautiful spirit outside of staring at men at bus stops, please hit up ttcharities.org. They always have something going on. They are their brother's keeper. Donate what you can, time, money, books, clothes, a like, a repost, a retweet. It all goes a long way. But ttcharities.org, hit them up. Donate what you can. And then as usual, I have my merch, whatistws.com/store. I'm guessing it's still some of the algorithm. I haven't taken the code down. But at some point it will come down. But right now, coupon code algorithm will get you 20% off your entire order. That's everything. T-shirts, hoodies, blankets, wall art, mugs, you name it. I got it. Not really, but I do have those things that I just mentioned. Hoodie season is coming up again, so where I'll be doing that run. I'm working on some new hoodies right now that I really like, and I'm excited to, you know, to see how people react to. But all right, some of the algorithm still going on. Coupon code algorithm get you 20% off. Hit up the store. Send Sheffy Lee's to Disneyland. And with that said, I'm really tired. I really don't know what I'm talking about anymore. And so yeah, I'm gonna let y'all go. If you listen to all of this, God bless you. You're amazing. You're amazing. I do have some guest spots coming up. I think I just did. I recorded a guest spot over the weekend that should be coming out sometime in October. So, you know, be on the lookout for that. It was a dope conversation about authenticity. I'll be giving you the details on that when I can think straight again. But other than that, y'all know what it is. Until we speak again, be safe, be the light, be easy. And I love y'all. I'm out of here.
Last call for alcohol. Yeah. If this is it, like if this is the last joint, if this is the last hurrah, it's the last call for alcohol, baby. I gotta say, whether you knew it or not, it's pretty much at the finest bar establishment, the finest spirits and libations y'all could have had, baby. You might realize it now, you might have realized it back then, you might realize it later.
Love.